Hi, I'm Henni Zuel. I played on the Ladies European Tour for 7 years and now I work at Sky Sports Golf. I'm going to share with you today a few of my first tee tips. If you don't have time to quite get down to the driving range, this is how you're going to loosen up your body and save those first few extra warm-up holes. The first one I'm going to show you is for your thoracic spine. This is primarily used for your rotation, so a key one to do. So this is a T-spine rotation. You're going to start with your feet hip-width apart, and then what you're going to do is go down so that your body's 90 degrees to the floor. This arm up, so both arms away, and you're going to go left hand to right foot, right hand to left foot. And try and keep your hips as still as possible so that it's your mid-back that is doing all of the mobilization. And you don't want to be doing this with hips. We're going to keep these as still as we can. So you should be feeling that in your middle of your back around here, and that's going to be the one that's going to help you to be able to rotate nicely. So action number two, we've done the top of the body, we're going to get the lower body loosened up nicely. This one is leg swings, really, really simple. It's going to get your hip flexors when we go back and it's going to get your hamstrings when we go forward. So balance yourself on a golf club, maybe the other way around, stop it from slipping. And have this hand out to balance yourself and you're just going to really simply go back and forward about 10 times. Try and keep your upper body as still as you can. No moving back and forth like that. And you should feel it nicely in the hip flexors and hamstrings, either side. Now, from that, do that on each leg. And then we're gonna go across ways to get your groin and then your outside hip. So this is great for your rotation on the way through. So same thing again, try and keep your body really still and stable, and then swing your leg back and forth. Okay, so we've loosened everything up, upper body, lower body. Now we're gonna wake it up a bit more and get a bit of a strength move in there so that everything's firing on all four cylinders. So this one, the overhead squat, try and get your longest club in your bag, longest iron in your bag, because the longer it is, the easier it's gonna be when it goes overhead for you. So starting position, club up overhead, arms nice and straight, feet a little bit wider than hip width, toes turned out because we want to be able to open up those hips and get down nice and low. And what we're going to do is just squat down and try and keep your shoulders as far back in that first position as you can. What they're going to tend to try and do is they're going to try and come forward as you go down. We want to stop that and keep them nice and back. So, like that, that's the start position. Just go down as much as you can, even if that's just 90 degrees or a little bit more, and back up again. Try and keep your knees out as much as you can and stop them from coming in, and shoulders back. And do that 5 to 10 times, by which point heart rate should be up, you should be feeling good and flexible and strong. So I hope that's been helpful. It's going to keep you a little bit less injury prone and hopefully get a few extra miles on your golf ball, as well as crucially not messing up that first tee shot. Enjoy your golfing endeavors.